Hello everyone, I hope you are having a good day today. My name is Sapnesh Naik and I am a full stack web developer. I specialize in Vue.js and Laravel and I have over 3 years of experience developing web applications using Laravel and Vue.js. And today, I am going to give you a glimpse of what all I know about these two technologies. So the application that I have built is a student management system. In this there are 4 types of users, namely admin, staff, student and parent, and each user can in turn have a set of roles, one or more roles. Roles are, for example, admin desk, exam staff and other roles, and this each role can have one or more permissions. Permissions are, for example, create admin, create student, create parent, create staff, view students, create role and all other such permissions. There are some 30 permissions. So all in all, there are around 43 API endpoints here in this application. And each API endpoint is mapped to one specific permission. So only if the user has that permission via the role, he will be having the access to the API.
So let us get straight into the application. This is the login page of the student management system. And we are going to log in as a super admin. What I mean by this is, this user has a super admin role. And I have used Laravel passport for the API authentication here. And you can also notice that there is no page refresh happening as the DOM is being changed dynamically by Vue.js. And this is the dashboard of the application. You can see that the dashboard has some information such as number of students, number of parents, staff and active admins. It also has the latest registered users. Now let us check out the profile page of this logged in user. We can go here. So the account details are the basic details which are required for login and password recovery. As you can see, the user's role is admin. And this is the profile of the admin. And this is the role assigned to this user, that is the super admin. And as you can see, this role gives him all the permissions available in this application. Now let us go over some of the functionalities in this project. Under user management, we have registration of admin, staff and student, and we can also view admins, parents, staff and students. Let us view students. As you can see, I am fetching the results in chunks. I am using Laravel pagination at the backend for this, and this data table is being implemented using AG Grid data table plugin in Vue.js. It has basic search and basic filtering options. So let us view one of the students, and this is the student profile. The student profile has a bit more details than the admin profile. It also has the address associated with it. We can edit any of these sections. We can edit the account details, including the password, profile details, address, and we can also assign or remove roles to this user. So as a super admin, even though I have all the access available to me, I might not want to do all of these operations by myself. I might want to delegate some of these operations to some other users, specifically to other admins. So that is where the roles and permissions come in. So let us see the permissions first. There are around 30 permissions in this project. So each permission, as I told you, is mapped to one specific operation, that is one specific API. So we can see each permission is part of which role. So this register student is part of super admin role and this role and also the test role. We can also view the role from here. Go to the role page. So you can see the super admin role has all these permissions and also these two users. It is being assigned to these two users. One of them is myself. So, and now if we see the roles list, you can see there are around 5 roles here. Each role has these many permissions. Some roles have no permission, that is also fine. And this each role is assigned to these many users. We can also view the role specifically. You can also edit the role. You can change its name. That is also possible. I will change the role from student to student A, and I'll input my password. it is asking me to add one permission. I will add it and I'll save it. So the changes were saved. Now if we visit the roles again, the name is changed from student to student A, that is fine. We can also delete a role only if it is not assigned to any of the users currently. This test role, which has no users currently, can be deleted. I will have to again input my password. So I will delete this role. So this role is gone now. So let us quickly create a role and assign it to a user. We will create a role to who has the permission to register a student. So I have listed here common operations and their required permissions. So to register a student, a role needs to have these all permissions: register student, register parent, search all parents, view specific parent, and search all staff. Register parent is needed because while creating a student, a parent profile needs to be created if it does not already exist. We also can link an existing parent to the student. That is why search all parents is required. And we can also view that specific parent details. And we also need the search all staff permission because a parent can also be a staff. So that linking is also possible. So let us create a role by the name of student registrar. I'll give my password. So the permissions required are register student, register parent, search all parents, search all staff, and view specific parent. So let me save this. So our role is created now. If we go into the roles page, we should see the student registrar role. Now let us quickly create an admin and assign this role to that admin. So we'll go into admin registration. We will say the admin is admin 2 at the rate of gmail.com. His login ID is automatically generated here. We'll give him a password. We can also change this admin ID if we want to, if we are sure that this login ID is unique. We'll enter an address. I'll try to autofill the address. I'll say permanent address is the same as communication address. I'll go to the next step. I will say he's a professor. Name is Lara Croft. Now we have come to the roles section. We can assign one or more roles here to this user. I will assign the student registrar role that we just created. As you can see, this role gives him these permissions. We can also assign multiple roles. And assigning a super admin role gives him all these permissions. We don't want that as of now. So we'll remove this role. We'll remove this role as well. So we can input our password because this is an authenticated privileged operation. Sorry. And we'll say submit. So the user is created here. If we go to the admins, you can see Lara Croft user. Here's a Lara Croft user. This was cached and just now it fetched from the backend. So there is also front-end caching available here. If we can search for Lara, we have Lara here. Now let us log in using this Lara Croft user and see what and all view he has. Now I will log in as the new admin that we just created. Now this admin should just have the access to register students and nothing else. As you can see, his dashboard is empty because there is a user stats API. He does not have permission for that API. And if we go to his profile, we can see that his role is visible, but he cannot view that role. And when I go to edit my profile, he only has options for account, profile, and address. There is no option for role because he does not have the permission. So if we go to his homepage, you can see there is no roles or settings option here because he does not have that permission. And if we go under user management, he only has the permission to register students. So this is what I was talking about. The dynamic nature of the UI, which populates the options based upon your permissions. Right, so you can mix and match permission like this into a roles and you can assign these roles to any users. So let us register a student. I will say the student's email ID is student2@gmail.com. The login ID will be automatically generated. I will give his phone number. The alternate phone number is optional, so we will not give it right now. The student can always log into his own profile and update these details if he wants to. I will try to autofill the address. I will say permanent address is same as the communication address. You can also give a different permanent address if that is your choice. So as you can see, the student profile has a bit more details, gender, prefix and such. So we will try to fill in these also. We can also give passport number and Aadhaar number. Aadhaar number has to be a unique and a valid Aadhaar number, because this is validated against the actual Aadhaar algorithm. We'll go next. Next, we have two options. The parent for this student can already exist in the system, or this parent might not exist and we'll have to create his profile. So I'll show the scenario where the parent already exists. We will try to search a parent. There is a fuzzy search implemented here. So if we search something, the query goes to the backend and the search results are fetched. So that is why we needed this permission, search parents. So if we select this parent, then we can see this is the parent's details. We can confirm it and then go ahead with the submission. Or else if the parent does not exist, we can say no and the parent creation form comes up. His parents' user details, parents' address details, parents' profile details. And here you can search for a staff. If that parent is already a staff, you can search for the staff. So here we have these three staffs. We can link this staff, existing staff, with this parent, so that it will be useful later to identify which staff childs are admitted into the school. So I'll go back to selecting an existing parent. I'll say SAP and search for someone. I'll select this parent and then I'll submit. So that was it. Alexandra is added to the system. With this, I would like to conclude this demo. Thank you for watching. And if you want more information about me, you can always go to my programming blog, kerneldev.com, kerneldev.com, and check out my other Laravel and Vue.js related stuff here. And you can also email me if you want to contact me for anything. My email ID is sapnesh@kerneldev.com. Thank you.